Hey everybody. So every month or so I do an update for what's coming up on the bench, and I don't know that I've ever really done a video about my workbench itself. As you can see, it's something more of a command center, really. First thing I should probably mention is the carpet on the floor. Couldn't tell you how big it is, but it neatly contains everything I need to, and living in an apartment as I do, I'm sure my landlord will appreciate that I haven't spilt paint, glue, putty, and all sorts of other stuff all over his carpet. I imagine if you live in a house and perhaps you're married, then your wife would also be similarly pleased, or your husband, or whatever, as well. So this pretty much contains everything, the workspace itself, really nicely. And moving up a little, obviously a comfortable chair is good. That one's only moderately so. And then the rest of the area is composed of a lot of different modular pieces. On the wall up there, we've got my on-the-bench workboard. So I know what pieces and what kits are where and at what stages. I work directly in front of a window so that I got a fan back there. Right now it's blocked off, but that allows for a painting booth immediately. I've got a TV up there, which is feedback for the camera, which is positioned nicely so all you guys can see what's going on. Then of course I've got the main bench there, a side bench here, a couple desks behind that, these little stands right there, plus some shelves sitting on the wall, and of course above the paint booth rather, I've got a series of shelves stacked there too for storage for paints, supplies, and clearly models on the top section there that I am working on that go on hold but need to be out of the way. And over in the corner there you can probably see a few paint cans hiding behind that lamp and the garbage bucket. So these are all real handy things to have here. I can keep some focus going on. So up there I've got the small rattle cans, mostly Model Masters, but some Tamiya and testers as well, and then I've got standard spray cans in there that sit and fit really nicely. The garbage can there is really handy, but more often than not stuff has fallen down that gap there. Lamps are obviously critical, and just between the two that are on here, I've got 150 watts going on, or 150 watts each. So there's 300 watts on the bench right here right now, which is pretty good brightness, but there are times when even more light is necessary or needed. Moving over here, the Dremel drill press is handy, and moving down here is where the Dremel actually lives, hanging off clips. I gotta say that having some hooks underneath your bench is definitely handy and very useful. C-clamps are definitely a good thing to have, and while we're down here, let's take a look over here. So I've got a speaker down there, which is the basis for this whole business. You can see that the paint booth itself is on wheels, and I try to have as many things on wheels as possible to help moving things around when I need to pull this apart for vacuuming purposes. So I've got my airbrush compressor, and I think that's like a 3-gallon tank on that, which is good enough, but something bigger would definitely be nicer. It used to sit right behind between the speaker there and the wall, but the whole thing acted like an echo chamber, so I've got it sitting on a few old pairs of chucks that helps minimize the vibration going into the floor, hopefully for the neighbors below me. And you can see right in there I've got nailed to the side of the speaker a power strip, which pretty much powers this entire area. And looking back there, I've got a 3-outlet extender, I've got another 3 outlets here, and even another 3 up there, just to make sure that I've got power where I need it. And I'm actually one short right here, so if I want to use the heat gun or the Dremel, I've got to unplug one or the other, which is a little too bad, but obviously another extension cord is all that's needed. But I'd probably put a power strip in there at this point, because that would be much more versatile. a lot of Dremel stuff mainly, and some miscellaneous crap the further down you go. Another air compressor, my old one, burnt out Dremel in there, and a device called the Drill Doctor, which helps sharpen drill bits. This stand here is amazingly useful, and again, having things on wheels makes it even more useful for moving around and being useful. Pens and some notepaper, always good to have. Then the top here is mostly miscellaneous junk that I randomly need or it just gets in the way. A couple model pieces right there. I didn't think when one of my buddies gave me this stand here, I didn't think it was going to be useful at all, but really it's turned out to be great. So I keep a lot of strip styrene in here, styrene tubes, styrene cuts, I-beams, anything miscellaneous in styrene, it goes in here. This is a miscellaneous drawer, semi-greeblies, but basically anything that's an odd shape that could be good for models later on. I throw in this little space here, that's a nice little bit of detail. Then comes the metal drawer, all brass, aluminum, anything metal, it goes in here, photo etch. Smaller tubes and pieces go in the middle, all the long ones go on the side. Very useful. Miscellaneous drawer of wires. Miscellaneous electronics, which actually has a lot of dollar store toys, such as these glow wands. I think this used to be part of a light-up Christmas tree. Some LED blinkers. No battery. Oh, there are batteries in this, but they're probably dead. Flickering RGBs and just miscellaneous electronics that I want to have around just in case. And then finally, it's all the sandpaper. And over here, you can see the airbrush right immediately. And what I've done with this is I put a stack of magnets on the side. Let me fix the focus here. There we go. So that's a stack of neodymium magnets. So, and I've also put magnets all over the bench itself. So wherever I need to hang the airbrush, as long as it's going on a piece of metal, basically it works out. Of course, having too many magnets gets to be a bit of a mess. Miniature flashlight for looking at the floor, for trying to find little pieces that get lost. Then having the magnets along the bench here is exceptionally useful because you can attach files to them and all sorts of things, LEDs, resistors, and they won't get lost, or at least they'll get a little less lost than they would be otherwise. You'll probably notice I got this black sheet of cardstock here. And that's basically to keep the bench itself relatively clean. I don't mind so much having it get dirty, but if I can pull this off without disturbing things, it really gets to be a mess. And when you're working on different models all the time, you're looking at a base mess rather than this way. I can just put a new sheet down, clip a couple magnets on top, and it stays right where it is unless you really pull. You got a basic paint box here, which generally protects the bottom side and allows me to pull it out for cleaning real nice and easy. I usually keep a couple big pieces of paper around for practicing on the airbrush itself or just help keep the mess down as well. And of course, nice clean cardboard boxes are great for spray painting in as well. And you'll see this large piece of cardboard here. Sorry about the focus. This is just jammed in to help keep the temperature stabilized inside. See, that's definitely a mess in there. I've definitely heard some warnings about using this type of fan. The aerosol from spray paint, enamel especially, can theoretically spark on the fan and cause either a little blowout on the fan or some flame or whatever. It's nothing I've seen yet in the last 5 years, but it is something I'm always on the lookout for. And we may as well talk about the soldering station here. This is a little wobbly right now, and I will be tightening it up at some point, but it basically serves its purpose. And again, all of this is just plugged in back through there. And since we're talking about soldering, we may as well look at the electronics as well. So I've got my buckets of LEDs, heat shrink, resistors, and some miscellaneous stuff going up here. Cans of air are always good to have around. I've got a few spools of different size fiber optics back there, and some other miscellaneous projects or electronics as well. So I've just got these huge, I don't know what they are, they're kind of hooks, but they're kind of rests, and basically the sander there and this drill sitting right here just fit really nicely and handily. And of course having the power button for the compressor right there is very handy too. The only downside to this is that the air vent, when you're finished, is on the far side. And here you'll see I've got another 3-power outlet, and this is just for running electronics that I'm working on for any particular model. Having that right there is exceptionally handy. Looking at the bench itself, some helping hands, then pretty much this is fairly modular overall. This used to be a computer desk stand before I put the Dremel drill press, and this surface here serves as a secondary storage platform for models currently in progress and pieces that don't fit on the bench itself. So the keyboard drawer is now my tool drawer. I should probably clear a few things out of here that I don't really need, but all the basics are here. Snippers, wire stripper, pliers, scissors. There's some lighters in here, screwdrivers, razor blades. Pretty much everything I need on hand right there. I'm always going into that drawer for stuff. And here's a spare pencil, which we'll put over in the pencil drawer. Up here, so again, spare model cans. This is actually one of the old Star Trek tins, which makes for a real sturdy storage bin. Gloves for painting, air masks. I've got some goggles hanging up there along with a couple of other air masks. Q-tips are kind of handy. Some popsicle sticks there as well. Looks like a box of plastic wrap. Then up here, decals, instructions, and reference. This is an exceptionally useful pile of stuff right there. Basically, anytime I get a kit and open it up, the instructions go straight in there, as long as all the reference and the decals. And one thing I'll mention about decals, before you use them, head over to your computer and scan them in at like 600 DPI, then use them. Having spares that you can modify and generate extras of later will be exceptionally useful for you. And over here, we've got a glue bucket with some baking powder for the super glue. Looks like I got some regular styrene glue in there, but mostly all the glue is stored down here under the computer bench, along with all my putties and stuff like that. And that bottom, it looks like some miscellaneous crap I probably got to sort out. But working up here, probably too much tape overall. Some fiber optics to work on, and then lots of magnets up here on the base of this lamp. Again, magnets are your friend, especially for blades. Just put them down and you know they're safe, and simultaneously they're at hand and ready for you. I should probably glue that down. So you got a mallet up there. We've talked about all the paints. Yeah, this is basically my paint supply up here, just to keep it all local and handy. So pretty much everything I need is in reach immediately when I need it. This lamp up here, being a clamp lamp, I can set that at any different height, so if I need to put more light on the table, I'll just unclamp it and lower it. This is definitely not a good thing, clamping it to the lamp, to the wires itself. I realize that. Don't get me wrong there. But it's something I've been living with for a while, and there have been no problems yet, but that doesn't mean that there won't be problems otherwise. So that's it for this one. Thanks for watching, as always. Appreciate everybody for subscribing, setting me up as your favorite videos, and propelling me to nearly 500,000 video views. I'll be hitting that in the next month or two, really. I'm just over 400,000 something now, 415, 420, somewhere around there. So that's really amazing to me. So happy holidays to everybody, and happy new year. See ya.